long as this stays this side of the leg, we're good. Well, here goes nothing. What I could find. Millimeter, by the way. Yuck. Back in for the time being. Get this thing repositioned. I'm going to get this thing so that it's facing this way here. It won't tip over sideways on me when I'm trying to do something. Get this oil out of here before this turns into a disaster. This on here for now. Not doing any harm.
We missed.
Same all the way down through. That was shorter. That was shorter. Somebody probably put this one back in the wrong spot. We're missing. That's interesting. We're already missing all of the ones down here. Oh, somebody took them all out of the cover already. Except for these that were behind the damper. There's one there. All right. 13 millimeter bolt. Gobs of silicone and some kind of a shank on this one. Wow, so much silicone up in the threads. I don't understand what's with this plastic. Looks like, I don't know. The only one that seems to have it. Centering maybe. Seems to be all of them. Now we get ready for the humongous mess. Double check, triple check, quadruple check. If we're not replacing the motor, we don't want to be replacing the oil pan too. Alright, let's get something underneath this mess. Just because I know this is going to go all over the place. Let's get this out of the way. Get this here. And hopefully all of the oil was in the oil pan. Screwdriver. Enhance. Oh, this isn't going to be fun. And we have the dipstick tube in the way. Yay! No mess, but a dipstick tube that's stuck in the way. Project diversion. Alright, well. Look at that. Humongous globs of silicone. And silicone stuck to the bottom of the pickup tube. Wow. All right. Let's get this back up. Place for the time being. Now we got the dipstick tube broke off and out of the way. Let's get this oil pan off completely once and for all. Let's see what we got. We've got more silicone and lots of sludge. Lots of, but I don't see any chunks. No chunks in here. That's kind of good, I guess. Get in here and Look at these journals. Sorry, the lighting isn't really good in here. This thing is really, really, really black. This thing is just yuck. And the inside of the, oh, look at all of the grit and yuck in there. Now, there's the reluctor gear. Can't say whether or not there's any black bearing journals in here, because well, everything's black. This front cover, you cannot get that off until you remove this bolt right here, which is the whole reason this engine has to come out of the stupid four-wheel drive to begin with, is because you can't get this front cover off without getting this bolt out, and you can't get this bolt out unless you drop the oil pan. You can't get the oil pan out because the sump's in the way and the four-wheel drive, and yeah, so here we are. Just to get to this point, and this thing doesn't even want to move. Ah, there's one more bolt right there. Okay, so we got three. There we go. That captured. And it appears to be, yes, it's a captured bolt. All right. All righty. Now we can start getting the front end apart. Water pump's loose. There's a water pump. More mess than I want to pick up. Nothing hidden in here anywhere. We just need another point somewhere near this pin. More coolant. Some coolant doesn't hurt the finish. All right. Now we can see what's underneath here. That's dry. That's all dry. Oil pump turns, that's good. We got a lot of polish on the inside of that chain. But, oh, I don't see anything yet. It's almost all the way out. Alrighty, well, I think next we're on to lifting those cams out. right in there. And then, from the looks of things, everything else on here is 8mm. Yeah, all the way down through. Let's get all these caps loosened up. Probably should also crack loose these cam bolts before I go any further. So that one is probably what, 17, 18. Nope. That's a goofy 16. Yep. Okay, let's see if this will do it. Nope. New battery. That one is a hex or a Torx or something weird like that. That one's pushing down, that one's pushing down, all the rest of these are not. See what we can do about getting that one cam bolt loose. That just simply means that now we have the means to get these off afterwards. Now let's go ahead and finish getting this cam out. Oh, I'm gonna have to tip this before all the rollers fall out. Tip this back a bit, I guess. All right. Gear is now out, chain is now dropped. Now let's bring this over in the light so you can see this thing. That's nasty right there. That one I can kind of feel a little bit, but I don't see anything. There's something right there, don't know what that is, but all right. Let's get the other cam out. And there's the other cam is looking equally nasty. Well, the 8th of November. This is where we're at. We've got the cams, followers, all out. We're kind of cleaning up it, the head right now. We're going to tip the head in a few minutes and get some more of this yuck drained out of it. And then we're going to pull all the hydraulic lash adjusters out. And we're going to add them over here with everything else that's in order. And neatly lined up, even though, as you can tell from the looks of these followers, that some of them really aren't looking healthy at all. The cam's not looking healthy at all, so we're actually thinking along the lines of remanufactured cylinder head for it, because, well, that just seems to make more financial sense at this point. These lifters that actually move around. Having a hydraulic lifter fall out wasn't something I counted on. Which one? I don't see one missing. What was that that fell out? What was that that fell out? Well, that could be a good reason for the engine binding up, depending on where this was. I wonder. I'm gonna try to keep these in the order they were in. Gotta make sure you got a good firm grip before you get started, otherwise you'll end up mangling the daylights out of it. Looking around in here trying to figure out where I put my pliers, I realized that we got RTV around that pickup tube and sludge all the way around it. I'm starting to wonder. There's the boy, that's probably what happened to this thing. Some didn't put it back together right. Anything rolling off the table. These are just yucky. They're all gonna get soaked and freed up if you don't replace the head. Oh wow, that one's really stuck in there. Now, if you have to really clamp on them, make sure you grab the outside edge here where those little burr marks are. That way there you're not hurting a machine surface. That was not an easy one to pull out. And last but not least, one more. There. Look at that yuck. Chain guide fell apart. A chunk of it missing right here on the edge. Didn't find that in the oil pan. There it is, in her entire blackness. Golden brown, golden brown, golden brown, golden brown, golden brown, and golden brown. And our rods. None of the rods look burnt or black. So we have not had any bearing issues in the bottom of this motor. Makes me a very happy camper. Now I'll get this stuff apart. Tensioner out of the way. Chain out. Guide plate. Chain's got a little bit of crazy wear in it. This is what the balance shafts look like. The two bearing surfaces, actually three up here. This is in fairly decent shape. Gears are a little crusty, they need to be cleaned up a little bit, but I think that's saveable. That's our new cylinder head in that big black box. This is our timing chain kit for the front and rear chains. Let's see, these are our head bolts. There's our head gasket. And the mess that's gonna end up going into the scrapyard. So we're as torn down as we're gonna get, with the exception of pulling the cylinder head off.